أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. إخوتي الأفاضل، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام
ورحمة الله. First of all, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most gracious, the most merciful. And as Muslims, we testify that there is none worthy of worship and praise except Allah. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final seal of all prophets and messengers that are sent to guide mankind from the darkness of disobedience towards the nur of Iman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us be amongst the guided ones. Whoever is seeking amongst us, may Allah be that person. Those who are going through trials, tribulations, temptations, and problems, may Allah ease their path. May He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make us be guided and be raised in the government as by us Muslims. Ameen. And brothers and sisters, welcome to the North Bricks Islamic Cultural Center here in London. Today we are going to look at the ayat of Ramadan, specifically about fasting, because we are just a few days away as Ramadan is approaching us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us in Rajab and Sha'ban. May He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make us witness the month of Ramadan. Ameen. As usual, I'm going to recite the verses and thereafter I will explain to you the nutshell meaning, and then I will pass the mic to the Abu Hamul Sheikh, a Sheikh Dr. Faisal Bouali, to tell us lessons learned from this wonderful ayat. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. أياما معدودات، فمن كان منكم مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر، وعلى الذين يطيقونه فدية طعام مسكين، فمن تطوع خيرا فهو خير له، وأن تصوموا خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان، فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصمه، ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر. يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر، ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون. وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعان، فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون. أحل لكم ليلة الصيام الرفث إلى نسائكم، هن لباس لكم وأنتم لباس لهن. علم الله أنكم كنتم تختانون أنفسكم فتاب عليكم وعفى عنكم، فالآن باشروهن وابتغوا ما كتب الله لكم، وكلوا واشربوا حتى يتبين لكم الخيط الأبيض من الخيط الأسود من الفجر، ثم أتموا الصيام إلى الليل ولا تباشروهن وأنتم عاكفون في المساجد، تلك حدود الله فلا تقربوها، كذلك يبين الله آياته للناس لعلهم يتقون. الله سيد. يا أيها الذين آمنوا، call me the believer, say, oh, you believe. Kutiba alaykum al-siyam. Fasting is prescribed to you. Kama kutiba ala al-ladhina min qablikum. As it was prescribed to those before you. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So that you may gain self-restraint, God-consciousness, piety, a demarcation between you and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dislike. Oh haram, make haram. أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَاتٍ. Fasting is for fixed number of days. فَمَنْ كَانَ مِنْكُمْ مَرِيضًا أَوْ عَلَى سَفَرٍ. Anyone of you who is ill or on a journey, فَعِدَّةٌ مِنْ أَيَّامٍ أُخَرٍ. They must make up for the prescribed number of days they've missed. وَعَلَى الَّذِينَ يُطِيقُونَهُ فِدْيَةُ طَعَامُ مِسْكِينٍ. And for those who are unable to fast, they must feed a miskin, a poor person, a day. فَمَنْ تَتَوَّى خَيْرًا فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَهُ. And whoever wants to do more and add to that, feed more than 1, 2, 3, etc., then that is good for the person. وَأَنْ تَصُومُوا خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. But for you to fast is much more better if you know. شَهْرُ رَمَضَان. The month of Ramadan, الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ. In which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Qur'an. هُدًى لِلنَّاسِ. It's guidance for mankind. وَبَيِّنَاتٍ مِنَ الْهُدَى وَالْفُرْقَانِ. And it's a clear sign of guidance and criterion or judgments for the entire ummah. فَمَنْ شَهِدَ مِنْكُمُ الشَّهْرِ. Whoever sees the moon, you sight the moon, فَلْيَصُومْ. Allah said that person must fast. وَمَنْ كَانَ مَرِيضًا أَوْ عَلَى سَفَرٍ. But whoever is ill or is on a journey, فَعِدَّةٌ مِنْ أَيَّامٍ أُخَرٍ. They must make up for the prescribed number of days they missed. يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to ease your body, wants to make things easier for you. وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرَ. He does not want to make things difficult for you either. وَلِتُكْمِلُ الْعِدَّةِ. And for you to complete those days, numbers of days, 29 or 30 days fasting, and after that, وَلِتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهُ. For you to send glory to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, praise Him again and again, glorify Him. عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ. For that which He has guided you towards. وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. By doing so, you may be guided to the straight, sorry, you may be someone who will show gratitude or grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah said after this ayat, talking about fasting, what you need to do, and etc. Now the next verse He said, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي. When my servants, they ask you about me. When my servants, they inquire about me. Allah said, فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. I am close, I am very close to them. أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ. I will answer to the call of the caller if he or she calls me. Whoever calls Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah said, I will answer to your call as long as you call me. But there is something we need to note here. Allah said, فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُ لِي. They must answer to my call first. وَلِيُؤْمِنُ بِي. And they must have faith and trust in me. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. By doing so, they may walk to the straight path. وَحِلَّ لَكُمْ لَيْلَةَ الصِّيَامِ. Permissible for you in the night of Ramadan. الرَّفَثُ. For you to approach إِلَى نِسَائِكُمْ, your wives or spouses. هُنَّ لِبَاسٌ لَكُمْ. Your wives are garments to you. وَأَنْتُمْ لِبَاسٌ لَهُمْ. And you are garments to them as well. علم الله أنكم كنتم تختانون أنفسكم. Allah knew, He knows very well that you used to hide while approaching your wives in the month of Ramadan in the night. But فتاب عليكم, He has pardoned you and also وعفى عنكم and forgive you. Allah has accepted your tawbah and forgive your pardon you. فالآن, now here is the good news. Allah said, باشروهن. Give them glad tidings. Approach your wives. وَابْتَغُوا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. Seek that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have decreed for you. And then Allah said, وَكُلُوا. Eat in the night.
واشربوا and drink حتى يتبين لكم الخيط الأبيض من الخيط الأسود من الفجر. Until you could distinguish between the white thread from the black thread in the night towards Fajr. And when you can distinguish between the black and the white thread, Allah said, at that time, stop eating. At Fajr, do not eat, do not drink, you must fast. ثم أتم الصيام إلى الليل. Fast up to sunset in the night, after month by Maghrib. ولا تباشروهن. But you must not approach your spouses وأنتم عاكفون في المساجد while you do اعتكاف the last 10 days in the masjid. تلك حدود الله. These are the perimeters, the boundaries of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. فلا تقربوها. Do not go beyond them. Do not transgress. And do not come closer to the boundaries of Allah. كذلك Allah said, indeed, this is how يبين الله آياته للناس. This is how Allah سبحانه وتعالى explicitly explained His verses to His mankind, His creation. لعلهم يتقون. So that they may gain piety. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى make us be amongst those pious ones, Ya Kareem. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us in this month of Sha'ban, and may He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make us witness the month of Ramadan. May the brothers and sisters in the deen, without much ado, I will pass the mic now to my Abul Sheikh, Sheikh Dr. Faisal Buadi, to tell us lessons learned from this wonderful ayat. فليتفضل الشيخ مشكورا.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله فشكر لك الله سبحانه وتعالى بأمانه بمعاصرة الإسلام يا مرقوته. وسأجيب الله سبحانه وتعالى has given us another chance so that you can ask for forgiveness and also a man our way of life. So the first and foremost thing that you have to do is to seek forgiveness. And how do you say it? Astaghfirullah al-Nazi, La ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum, wa atubu ilayhi. Astaghfirullah al-Nazi, La ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum, wa atubu ilayhi. Astaghfirullah al-Nazi, La ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum, wa atubu ilayhi. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it for us. Well, we are dealing with the month of Ramadan. It is a very important month in our life and also in the year. Because in which the Quran was being revealed by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And at the same time, in which there is a night that is better than any kind of worship apart from that particular month. Better than 1,000 of that is known as Laylatul Qadr. But fasting is not a matter of having someone to become, for example, Allah wants us to punish us for us. No, it's not a punishment. But instead, it's for us to purify us, for us to come more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And hence, there are adab, etiquettes of fasting, or observing the month of Ramadan. And among these etiquettes, the Sheikh to Yusuf to write a report for me. Now, among some of the etiquettes that you have to do when you are fasting, the first one, when you are fasting, because you have to gain something which is very important, and that is at-taqwa. You want to gain at-taqwa from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is called consciousness. This is the first thing you want to gain from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, what one has to do, apart from that, iqdar al-sadaqah. Make a lot of sadaqah. in the month of Ramadan, make it a lot of salah. Because Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has said, Yawm al-Qiyamah, everyone will be under the shade of his or her salah. And the salah also is very important because it distinguishes the anger of your Lord. And it brings you also to preserve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is the parents also for you in your Qabr. So it is very important. That's why it is said that Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he was generous throughout the whole year. But in the month of Ramadan, he was more generous, more faster than what? He was more generous, more faster than
someone says the lightning. Okay, inshallah.
You don't know when what is called the storm is coming. You see the what is called the wind. It comes very, very fast, isn't it? Yes. He says the person says he was more faster than that. In the giving, such a power. Because what is the reward that you gain outside of Ramadan of doing farad? In Ramadan, you do the sunnah, you get that of a farad. And it goes more and more for you. So, the individual should try as much as possible to do a lot of sunnah. That is one. And secondly, Iqtar al-Birr, you have to do a lot of righteousness. Anything that you bring to process Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Doesn't go to people. Say something which is good. Or teach someone something about the deen. For example, the Qur'an and the other things and so on and so forth. All these things here are very, very, very important that one should try as much as possible to do during the month of Ramadan. Because when you do that, it brings you closer to Allah. It purifies your tongue. It purifies your deeds, your actions and so forth for you. Hence, in the month of Ramadan, people should do a lot of righteousness. Do as many times as you don't have any limit to it. No, no. You don't have any limit. And you will not make someone prevent you from doing it. You see, some people, for example, every day is doing something good, and somebody comes and says, you always want to do this and that, so you want to show up. Because this one has told me that, therefore I have no more way to do it.
No.
Maybe she should have said that one right person to come and prevent you from getting what you are supposed to get. Were you doing that because of that person? In the first place? Or were you doing that in order to get the pressure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? If you are doing it to get the pressure of Allah, then you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there. And this is what you are doing it for. But if you're doing it for other people, and then they tell you to have stuff because you're doing it for them. So that is one thing you have to bear in mind when you're doing this kind of act of worship. And do a lot of tasbih. Lot of tasbih. And that is Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah. لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. All these things you said, because each one of them is a sadaqa for you, and that also it goes up, it fills between the heavens and the sky. So the believer should boost your success. You have to top it up. You don't have a specific time, that is, for example, after Salah, that's the time, you see that it says, SubhanAllah, Alhamdulillah, and so on and so forth, so, then three times.
No, anytime you do a lot of this, you do a lot.
And also a lot of istighfar. Istighfar is very, very important. As I said, may the person be blessed who will get a lot of istighfar in his skill, Yom Kippur. So, when the person was asked, what would bring us closer and make us enter Jannah, what did he say? He says, the fear of Allah and the righteousness of conduct. Your behavior is very important. So the etiquette of a person, one has to have the best behavior. The Muslims are supposed to have the best behavior. But in the name of God, let it be more. Let it be more. Have the best behavior. Among the etiquettes, you have Qadab and Qadab. You have control your anger, suppress your anger. But unfortunately, it is opposite. In the months of Ramadan, when the Prophet fasts, there's a time that they come more anger. In many shows of Masalites, you see them fighting. Some people are aiming, using the knife, and they're open.
Why do you have to fight?
If what the person is saying is not true, why should you fight for it? Do this ihsan. What's the meaning of ihsan? Ihsan means to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if you are seeing Him. In other words, you become more conscious in every aspect that you believe. Because Allah is watching you. Even if you do not see Him, He is what? So this is the most important. This is the whole thing about the Ramadan is that is the God of consciousness. And then the next aspect you have to bear in your mind is to judge Ma'ara Ramadan. To avoid and abstain. Abstain from what Allah had forbidden. Abstain from what Allah had forbidden. Among them, backbiting. This is a very, very serious thing. And this is something which is much more easier on the tongues of people instead of afflicting. Backbiting. Same thing about someone and so on and so forth. This one will do this, or that one will do that. Professor Sun has said, man and the Nadiata, Kawun the Rasul, well, I'm going to be. Whosoever does not abstain from false statements, and then acting upon it, but quieting and so forth, doing it ignorant things, and that has nothing to do with what is fast. To leave your food and then your water or drink and so forth, just kill them. So many people will fast in the Pakha Buddha and set the Pakha Buddha in the first class. There's no reward. May Allah set us from that. Among some of the things that you have up here in mind is you have abstained from Asada or Shadda. You have to abstain from insulting the people and cursing people. So when he will use foul languages, for example. Nowadays, as here they call it, F's and whatever it is, and so on and so forth. All this is a person must abstain from. you should not make that point. That's why you have to train yourself before that month comes, so that you will not involve in that. Okay? Train yourself more with this. If something happens and so forth, you know, this is something like this. And then it becomes part of you. So that the month of Ramadan, if something happens, it comes to you automatically. For you to use this kind of words. Another one also is avoid listening to things that Allah are forbidding you to listen to. Don't listen to that. Or looking at things that Allah had put in or looking at. All these things, you see, the extent of the month of Ramadan is the training ground. For us. So this is something you have to bear in mind. And also to take your sukur. Taking the sukur, that means pre-dawn meal. The pre-dawn meal that you have to take, it is baraka. The Prophet said, there are a lot of baraka in it. Baraka. Okay? So it is good. Try to take your sukur. Because there are a lot of baraka blessings in it. Even if you cannot eat it, some people, when they cannot eat in the night, for example, but at least get some water or something like that. But try to avoid the foods that are rich in soil. You know what's in soil, isn't it? That's what. Salty things. Okay? Try to avoid it. But try to get it with that of potassium. Okay? The food that is very rich in potassium, you should try to get it. So you can write that for like bananas. Because bananas, it will taste. It will taste the water. Okay? It helps you to do that. And also get milk. And you get dates. For example, you get some dates. And avocados. You know avocados? Yeah. How do you call it?
Pear.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's on the
pear. All right.
It's pear, actually.
Okay. That's a big one. I've covered. Okay. And then dry peaches.
Dry peaches.
Peaches.
The peach.
Okay. You get some of that also to eat for your soul.
Yeah, my. These are peaches.
You get pumpkin. It's still pumpkin. To break your heart. Pumpkin is very, very good.
Pumpkin. You have pumpkin here? We call it pumpkin.
It's very good and soft and soft. Okay. It helps you a lot. Okay. And at the same time, get some.
If the clock is the time,
and if
I was thinking, which is at that time, stands. Mm-hmm. 0 o'clock.
You get some potatoes.
Mm-hmm.
Stop. If in the case that you want to eat bread, for example, try as much as possible to get.
Yeah, some people, for example, they make the timetable yourself. Brown 10 minutes before, or 10 minutes before. This. No.
And you can have some rice.
You can eat bread until when you hear the answer.
You can eat much longer. All these things, it helps you stop during that time. But the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has said,
so this thing is very good for you during that time when you are eating.
Delay your soul,
but when you are making the iftar,
break your heart.
Don't start with heavy things.
When you are making,
for example, it's a good time.
Don't start
with
it's about, you know, and so forth, dates. Fruits, for example.
If 3 o'clock,
you don't have them. That's the thing.
Time starts, which is as that time starts.
3 o'clock. Water, something, you know, something very soft.
You stop eating.
Why? Because your stomach, when you do not eat, the stomach.
Some people, for example, they make the timetable, you said 10 minutes before,
and it is food
15 minutes
what?
Before this.
No. Gas.
You can eat and drink until when you hear the azan.
That's why some people, they sit the and they feel what?
Then you stop.
Pains and so forth. Why? Because the stomach is full of gas.
So this
and
is very,
very
good for you during that
time.
When you are eating.
When you eat something,
and
heavy,
when
it
you're
is
making
not
the
prepared for that.
Don't start with heavy things.
Accommodated.
When you're making it for
you need to go to Africa.
Don't start with heavy.
Yes, yes. And
you know,
and
come
to
place and so forth. Fruits, for example.
And if you don't have it, that's the thing.
Get something,
get something
expensive so that you wake it up a bit of it. Then after that, so in other words, before
so that,
your stomach,
your stomach. When you do not eat,
but you not
the stomach becomes what?
So that after Salat, then you come.
And it is food that what?
Gas.
Yes. Of gas.
And also try as much as possible.
That's why some people, when they sit away, they feel what? Pains and so forth. Why? Because the stomach is full of gas and it is very, very small the time.
That
when you eat something heavy, it is not required for that.
So accommodated.
Where we eat with food.
Okay. So when we have, say, well, if I'm not prepared,
and
in your time to make it, I'm going to pinch
this one. It's not good.
There is that.
Let him get something warm.
Somebody starts with
get something, get something like this. Expensive. So that you wake me up a bit by a bit. Then after that,
it is not cold.
So in other words, before your salad, you get a little bit of something like
this. But not the ones that you put in the fridge. Until
like
even you see this one like a smoke all over it.
So by that time,
that's why it's a fire by itself. Okay.
And also try
right. So you should not start with something like that.
Not to start with
something
that
is more
very, very cold.
So that it will help you with the digestions and everything.
Why?
It comes with it also during that time. Which is very
important. Why should you start with cold drink?
Start water.
Yeah, cold drink.
Why?
Pressurizing it. Your stomach with things that is not
food.
And also, after iftar, for example, don't do exercise.
This one is not good for you. The person gets something
because the blood,
even the water, something like this, you can drink.
It's only certain around the stomach.
This one, it is not cold. It's just normal. You can drink something, but not the ones that you put
therefore
in the fridge
the
until even you see this one like they smoke all over it. So hard, you know.
When you start,
that's what it's a fire by itself.
Exercise, for example,
all right. So you should not start with something like that. No, start with something which is warm.
That also
so
makes
so that it will help you with the digestion.
It seems you have how to avoid
it.
Maybe after maybe a few hours.
It is very good for you
like that.
To start with, instead of pressurizing your stomach with things that is not prepared for that.
No,
and also,
that is one thing.
Immediately after iftar,
the next aspect that you have to bear in mind,
don't do exercise
what some people
after iftar, for example. Why? Because
especially
the blood
in Salat Tarawih,
the flow of the blood
in Salat Tarawih
is only
which is completely bid'ah.
So
completely bid'ah, and people should avoid.
Because here you have eaten, therefore the blood
the person
it has
who is not leading the Salat
only around the stomach itself.
Or the one who is not
so
there,
when you start do more exercise, strenuous exercise, for example, immediately after that.
Yeah.
You put not attention.
Every masjid, even in Mecca,
and that also makes you feel stomach.
Oh, during our time, we used to have one slide.
This seems you have to avoid it
always.
Maybe after maybe a few hours, or something like that,
and
then you are to do some exercise if you want to do
Medina.
But not immediately after the iftar, just like that.
You do not hold the mushaf.
No, that is one thing.
You.
The next aspect that you have to bear in mind is what some people they do.
You don't hold the mushaf.
Especially in Salat Tarawih, especially
with the absorption or the reason that
which
I
is
am referring
to the bid'ah,
what the Imam is reading.
No, the repeatable bid'ah and people should avoid.
This one is mukhalafa. This one
a person who is not reading the salah
teachings of
or the one
salat
who is not there to correct the Imam.
Because when you perform salat, you need something known as khushu.
You know, sometimes in every masjid,
and
khushu in Mecca,
you cannot gain that khushu.
Oh, do you know what time?
You know what is, mashallah, they say they have smartphones.
Who always
as soon as they come, even the person comes late,
the Imam makes a mistake.
The first thing he has to do,
okay? You do not hold the mushaf.
What are you doing? Are you reading? Or you are asking? What are you really doing?
The person who is following the Imam, you don't hold the mushaf.
So you are not following the Imam.
With what?
And you said when you are performing salat,
with the assumption or the reason that
the right
I am following
on what?
What the Imam is reading. No.
So that you gain the khushu.
This one is mukhalafa.
And you focus.
This one is contrary to
where you are going to do what?
Teachings
of your sajda.
The salah itself. Because when you perform salah, you need something known as.
So by having these things here, how are you going to focus on that?
Okay. And for sure, you cannot gain that for sure.
And then you make
her. Nowadays, mashallah, is that they have smartphones. As soon as they come,
so movement,
maybe the person comes
not necessary.
The first thing is. In your
salah.
Among them,
opening
some so
forth. Now they are not going to look for
with
the
tape.
And
the eye.
What is it?
You are not the one who did the
salah.
You are just a follower.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
You are just a follower.
And Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam
has
said,
my
mind has
made
for you
to follow. So
what
is
reading? You become
quiet
and listen
to him.
And some of them go as far as reading with the imam. When the
imam
is reading, they are reading with the imam.
That frustrates so many worshippers.
You see?
And sort of chaos.
And that is something which is very bad. One should not do that. If you are performing
salat,
Listen to it and contract. But by looking at all these things at the end of the day, it will even take you out that you may even forget that you are salat. Except the person who is there to correct the Imam.
For example, sometimes the basis of mistake.
Alright? There could be someone who is assigned,
who insists,
have done the Imam, should in
case
mistakes
comes.
He can tell the Imam, come back and correct
that kind of mistake.
So these things are very important for people. Now you go to the masjid, when you go to the tarawih, everybody is going to be there. Smart, 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 smart.
Where did you get this from? where do you get all this list from?
No.
Listen to it. And by listening to it and so forth, it helps you to give you a lot of type of susto. And concentrate it.
How is it saying it?
This is very, very, very important. Therefore, if anybody has something like that, try to avoid. If you want to gain the attitude, the reward of your salat, then stop it. But if you don't want it, and you want to go with empty hands, then do it. No problem, you can do it.
But you go with empty hands. Because if the demand is not there, tranquility and
Khushu
is not there.
And once this one is not there, where is your salat? There is no tranquility. There is no Khushu. Where is your salat?
What did you get?
And then
those people who don't gain this distance,
Yes, salat will be
raised. Every salat you perform is being raised. He said, but the salat will be raised up, but in the form of a smoke.
And when it reaches by the first sky,
it has not entered, you know.
He said, this one will be not acceptable to enter here.
He said, return it and throw it to the face of one who did it.
Look.
He said, say that
Salah that can have it in the smoke. If you do what?
The angel will bring it and throw it at the face of the person who did it.
You perform Salah in order to gain what?
You pray in order to gain what?
The acceptance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Isn't it?
But here, your salat has come with a curse upon you. You pray to curse yourself. You pray in order to curse yourself.
SubhanAllah.
That's what I said. For where do you need to sin? What?
Ansalatin.
Sahul.
You see, people sometimes you read all this ayat. And you do not contemplate what it means.
He said, who want to people? Curse upon the people who perform salat.
Okay? But
the heedless of salat.
Isn't that this one? You said so.
You are more focused on this one.
And if the phone becomes a little bit, you have to press one side in order for the light to come on. To see it.
Is it?
All these things you do.
There is no shoe.
That's it. So all these things can be avoided.
If you want to know where the Imam has been, ask someone who was following, would the Imam have been so forth?
Do not recite it. When the Quran is being recited, what is that? He said you should listen to it. And you should be quiet. Meaning you have to be attentive to it. So people looking inside their phones and so on and so forth, following the imam, in Tarawih, all these things are issues of quiet. Or taking the maswaq in order to follow the imam.
No. Just leave it. You listen to the imam. When you go home,
you can go ahead and see those who are right and so on and so forth.
What the imam has, right?
This is something which is just very important that you have to bear in mind when you are performing Salat al-Tarawih with the Imam. One, avoid looking in the masjid. Or your smartphones and so forth. Okay? And secondly, you should also avoid reciting or reading the Imam. It's very important. Avoid reading with the Imam. When the Imam is recited,
you become quiet and listen. That's what I'm talking about.
Say,
be quiet. Be attentive. That's it.
You did not say read with him. Did Allah say
read with him?
No.
Allah did not say that.
So you become quiet and listen. And who got the ajr? You get the reward for listening. And then
what of being attentive, paying attention to it, you can get this.
You know, sometimes what we have been taught to do, that you get more ajr, you don't want to do that. The one that we do not get attentive, that's what our effort and focus on it. It becomes our main focus.
It shouldn't be like that.
The next part that you have in mind, there are some people who maybe in the last year's fasting, for example, they were unable to fast because of the permissible excuse. For reason for him or her, especially the ladies, not to fast, especially if she sees his messages during that time, for example. The matter of God, she is not allowed to fast.
Isn't it?
So it's maybe three or four or seven days, for example. They will not perform after the month of God, throughout the whole year, they will leave it. Instead of making up for that one, they will leave it until the next year's Ramadan starts. And then you ask a question.
Why did I do that? If you phone someone and the people come to you, you'll be very prepared, isn't it? But it's a day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what do you have to do? So you have to do it. Even if it is just one month, for example, even if it is 30 days.
Let's say 30 days that you have missed. Can't you 11 months finish paying for that?
Let's say you have about six days or seven days, for example, that you missed in the last year's Ramadan.
Maybe we do one or two.
And so, why didn't you finish it?
The only thing is, when you do not finish it, the next month comes, you have to make this bar and so forth. And how fast the one that has come? Still, that one that you did last year.
It does not. Go. It's still there.
After that one has come. Now the question is,
especially the ladies who said, well, is it allowed? Since I want to show that. I went a lot and I passed. The whole one, the one, the men's sense is coming. Okay. Well, the answer to this is, if it is not harmful, if it is not something to become harmful, the body of that lady, for example, then there's nothing wrong about that. To that lady, the body of the lady, then we should avoid it. So it is within your own description, especially the ladies. When I say harmful, what does that mean? It means that after the month of Ramadan, if it will not interfere with the days of your menses. Because irregularities has come in now. Take pills to prevent, like people who go to high five, for example, they like to take pills and support, or tablets, so that they will not have their menses in the time. You can do it as long as it will not harm you, but if you know that it will cause you harm, then you do not do it, because it's a source that Allah has given to you. Stop. Of taking it. Then after that, you can do it. Okay, now the next question is about if my menses. I know that I do some things and so forth. After four or five days. I see some blood or something like that coming out of that. What should I do? Well, as far as the time is concerned, when you see it, it enters the system, when you see it, it enters the system. You just push it and then continue to your fasting. Also, another time. You have no problem about that. Okay. All right. No. Can you stop?
Yeah.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward Muhammad Sheikh this wonderful, for this wonderful session he has presented to us today. Very, very educative, and we need to take advantage of it. May Allah reward our Sheikh and preserve him for us, give him health, make him healthier again and again. Alhamdulillah, we need to be more young to eat.
MashaAllah.
Yeah, the pounded one. The pounded one, right?
Good.
I just want to summarize for you what the Sheikh just said. I'll see you benefit from that, inshallah. I'm looking after one. The Sheikh, after we recited the ayat, the verses of Siyam fasting in Ramadan, the month of Ramadan, and what constitutes the whole process of fasting, the Sheikh said there are points you need to take on board. That the purpose of fasting is not just for you to feel hunger and also as well going out there saying, oh, I'm thirsty and etc. No, but you have to understand that you must gain something very important called taqwa Allah, the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In other words, God consciousness or self-restraint or demarcation, piety, whatever way you want to call it. And then he said, one of the things that we should be doing in Ramadan all the time, before Ramadan now gets yourself involved in that. The first one is charity, sadaqah, very, very important. It cools the heart of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it opens the door of charity. I mean, provision for you, he said. He mentioned that in detail. I'm not going to do that. Inshallah, I'm just giving you the nutshell or just the points. And the next thing they say you should engage yourself in is righteousness, good deeds. Do not let any good deed slip away from you. Get involved in righteous deeds. Do one good deed and follow it with another one. And the Sheikh mentioned that. And he talked about the importance of these good deeds is what I'm here after. May Allah reward you for that, ya Kareem. And he shared about the things you should be doing in Ramadan, dhikr, glorification, remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said with that dhikr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said it brings tranquility into your mind. And also as well with dhikr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you become closer to him and he will protect you. He elevates you through that act. May Allah make us be a Muslim. And he said we should seek forgiveness for all times, at all times. And he mentioned that to all of us saying, Astaghfirullah, la ilaha illa huwa al-hayy al-qayyum, wa atubu ilayh. You seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You turn to him with repentance again and again. It's what you should be doing. And then the other thing he says is about you restraint your anger. Wow. Some people, when they are fasting, they say, don't worry, I'm fasting now. Wait, let's finish the fast.
Hey,
your fasting, he says, look, this is fasting, right? Wait, let's finish. Immediately when you finish it, then I will show you. That basically, the Sheikh says that's not fasting. So therefore, please do not engage yourself in anger. And anger, one of the weapons of Shaitan that he uses to destroy human beings. Because when one gets angry, all the faculties of thinking and etc. are weakened, then Shaitan comes and attacks you. In that time, if Allah did not guide you, you will not think appropriately. May Allah save us from that. And then the Sheikh talked about something very important. When he said Ihsan, I thought it's the other kindness. And he mentioned the Ihsan in the hadith of Jibreel when he came to the Rasul. When the Rasul asked about Ihsan, and then he said, it's for you to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ka'annaka tarah, as if you see him. فَإِنْ لَمْ تَقُمْ تَرَاهُ فَإِنَّهُ يَرَاكَ. But if you do not see Allah, Allah sees you. So when you stand in front of Allah in salah, stand there with devotion. And the Sheikh elaborated on this deeply. And brothers and sisters who stand there using their phones, and then, subhanAllah, one is doing the phone them, and then he mentioned the ayah from Surah 2.
And there will be punishment for those who pray, those who are negligent.
We Allah said, for Waylul Lil Musallin, sorry, so please do not, that there will be punishment for those who pray, those who are negligent in their prayer. And the Sheikh elaborated on that. So please do not be negligent in your prayer. And when you stand there, all for sure.
And the Sheikh
said, wants to attain self.
One of the things very important, you must always engage yourself in
Allah grant us to abstain from all haram. And the Sheikh said, one of the things very important, you must always engage yourself in is to abstain from all haram.
I eat backbiting, inshallah.
Some people, they promise. Sheikh said, the Prophet said that some people when they fast, they don't have anything. But what?
They eating people's flesh all day.
And thirst. Because they've already been eating.
Subhanallah.
They're eating people's flesh already. The whole day.
Mr.
A, Mr. B, Mrs. C, Mrs. That. Subhanallah. That one is short. That one is tall. What is your problem? No, not the creator. That one puts on blue. What about you? You put on black. Did they talk about you? So abstain from this. And then the Sheikh said, you abstain from that. Liar. All qawl zur. False. In statements. You must abstain from them. Otherwise, you have nothing except hunger and thirst. And then Sheikh said also as well, you must abstain from insulting and cursing people. Some people wherever they are, Allah is there. When you see them, you realize that the presence of Shaitan is here. MashaAllah, they enjoy fighting. And then they will tell you, MashaAllah, I will show you this one in the first time. Say, I will show you today. Hey!
And then the Sheikh said,
I will show you. Please abstain from insulting and using music words and languages. And then the Sheikh said also as well, you should be avoiding listening to haram, like music. In Ramadan, why are you listening to music?
Become enjoyable.
The Quran. And whoever is used to this music and all this haram stuff, khalas, the Quran will not become enjoyable to you. They will not enjoy the Quran. To be honest with you, once you enjoy haram, then you will not enjoy the halal. So may Allah give us all this fitna, ya Kareem. And then he said
but the
about
so the
Freedom Bill.
He said if you cannot eat, at least water.
Right? Especially like me, who struggle to eat in the morning.
Get tea, like
but the Sheikh made it so easy. He said if you cannot eat, at least water, right? It's the same soul.
Inshallah.
Get tea, like a legible.
Always. You don't have anything except
I'm telling you. Nice tea and bread in the morning.
Inshallah.
Inshallah. If you don't have anything except
no problem. As long as
once you eat rice as well as yam,
because Gary will make you drink water the whole day.
No problem. As long as some people eat that food. And if you eat Gary, it's a problem. Because Gary will make you drink water the whole day. So that's what makes it a problem for you. You understand? So don't go to Ghana and eat Gary. So anyway, the Sheikh talked about his Freedom Bill, that when you eat, your Sunnah says,
what do we do?
Eat Sahur because you get blessing in it. And the Sheikh talked about something very important here, about the Sahur, what do we do?
We wash it. Right?
We delay.
When we say rushing,
right?
The time has
and then
to
the iftar.
You don't rush it before time, not in time.
Rush
time.
Right? Yeah. But when we say rushing, the time has to be you don't rush it before time, not in time, on time.
However, when the time is due, do not delay.
And this way you delay, the Sheikh mentioned something very important. Some people are saying 1 hour, I was taking off, it's 1 hour before
Adhan or 1 hour
before Salah, sorry, Adhan, is it Adhan or 15 or 5 minutes before Adhan or 10 minutes? Sheikh said no, one should eat until when the Adhan is called. When you hear the Adhan, that reminds us of Adhan. Some brothers, they eat. And then they have some food in the mouth. And then he said, when you're breaking your fast as well, don't take those
mashallah,
big jobs.
You see
some brothers or sisters, if I don't breakfast with the sisters, mashallah, the brothers
when you see the back.
You had that one, they have cassava. You know cassava, yeah?
And the other one,
big chunk. And that one, they have full fries. And the other one, they have kenke. And the other one, they have big potatoes and then rice. Big jock of meat. Mashallah, alhamdulillah, Allah has blessed us with this here in Jesus. We don't struggle with your food. Alhamdulillah, it's a mercy from Allah. And if we thank Him, He will continue to reward us in Christ. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us be among the grateful ones here, Kareem.
So take something light.
My dear brothers and sisters, the Sheikh said, it's not healthy for you. It's not healthy at all. So take something light. Alhamdulillah, this masjid is just fresh. Whole lot of Alhamdulillah. Not boastful.
And you got
Alhamdulillah. You got three main courses, right? You got the
when
starter.
You starter.
Is it the starter?
Yes.
And you got what? The main course. And you got what?
The dessert.
When do you take the starter?
When do you take the starter? For us here, the starter.
And the pudding. Mashallah. On the dessert. When do you take the starter?
Before Salah.
For us here, the starter. I'll take it before
Salah. So this one.
Or during iftar, actually.
So during this time, before take the light. Like
before Salah.
Inshallah, and now, nice
so this is what we have here, alhamdulillah. So during this time, take the light like food. Inshallah, and I have nice words on porridge. Alhamdulillah, don't take like too much hot water.
Inshallah, when you put it there,
so you see someone hold the mouth, they keep blowing inside. Have you seen that?
Yeah.
Alhamdulillah, we have lots of them around there. So you eat this
yes. And the don't blow the food itself. Oh. Yeah, because blow the food itself. Yeah. But say they had it because I want to benefit them. Yeah. Just say
no, they don't blow the food itself. Benefit.
Yeah. Yeah, because blow the food itself. But say they had it because I want to benefit them. Yeah. Just say it had it so they will benefit. Yes.
Mashallah. He said because the hot one, there's no barakah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes. Mashallah.
He said because. The hot as one, said, mm-hmm. There's no the hot.
Yeah.
The hot one.
What is it? You cannot yeah. Even keep it in your mouth.
Said,
it goes so there's no barakah in it. Okay? And not only
what
that.
What is it? You cannot yeah. Even keep it in your mouth.
When you are eating, and especially so no when you are eating,
okay?
Well, and not only that,
as this means
the pretty food.
When you are eating,
don't start from
especially when you are eating,
well, don't start to go and keep.
They bring the food.
Because
don't start from the middle.
The baraka.
Beautiful. Don't start to go and kill from the middle.
Nobody just got the baraka there. There. He said the baraka, the blessing.
Nobody just got the baraka there.
I live with them.
He said the baraka, the blessing. It comes from the sky.
No.
It comes.
It's from the part which is
of the food. And it's
so and also Mina Adab, so don't go and eat from in front of someone.
From the
for example, you see that some people when they come, so they sit.
Also,
so
Mina Adab,
looking at
don't go and eat from in front of someone. For example, you see that
Musa,
some people when they come, they sit. So they're looking at
when Musa is not eating, they're going to take it for them.
Like
a chunk of two. May Allah reward you, Sheikh, for this wonderful. It's very very important for what the Sheikh has said. And okay. The brothers and sisters learn this yeah, etiquette.
May Allah reward you, Sheikh, for this wonderful. It's very, very important for what the Sheikh has said. And I'm glad that brothers and sisters learn this etiquette. Because sometimes he irritates some other people, they come, they complain.
And Islam,
and then sometimes when they see eating there, they don't want to eat anymore. They just put up because of the way people eat. And Islam, alhamdulillah, the Sheikh is mentioning here, the Rasulullah SAW explained everything to us. Adab, akhlaq, how we eat, how we talk, how we walk, how we look, etc. Well, the Sheikh said
as well, that try to eat food that has
and then the Sheikh said, sorry, it's locked, not just summarizing that, we're almost coming to the end. The Sheikh said as well, that try to eat food that has potential, right? Not food that too heavy, like potatoes, and he said with bread, even bread, the brown bread, yeah, it's good. Alhamdulillah, we have white bread, blue,
and he said that
mashallah, green one, it's down there, and he said with bananas. Yeah, but that is as well. That's good. And he said, like milk. Who's above all the most important one is dates.
Yeah, he gets 3 dates.
Where is your brother? Dates is in Bogart. Who was it? Yeah.
And then you eat.
Just finding the good job of cassava now. Yeah, he gets 3 dates. Since he's 3 dates at least.
So,
and then you eat it.
And he said,
it doesn't matter if you can eat this seed, no problem. But just me that seed. So you will not break your teeth.
And we call it.
Alhamdulillah.
Never used to like
so, dates. And he said as well, avocado. Because the Sheikh loves
avocado.
And we call it beer. I never used to like it.
You know, like it.
Until when I came here, class, I come from Bukavu. Now, the next one the Sheikh said, yeah. you know pumpkin?
Okay.
No peaches, pumpkins as well? And the Sheikh said,
Now, after that, the Sheikh talked extensively.
Peaches, isn't it? Dry peaches.
The
dry peaches. Now, after that, the Sheikh talked extensively about the recitation in Salah. When the Imam is reading,
but when one
if one hold the Quran to correct the Imam, for example,
they hold the Quran,
hold the Quran
then Falah Haraj, the Sheikh said.
But when one holds the Quran, amazing,
Allah.
They hold the Quran for them to look, for them to read and see where the Imam is reading. And sometimes the whole day just for them to be, not for them to attain khushu.
That salah does not
and that one, Shaitan use it that one to deviate them from their salah. And when you don't have khushu, then that salah does not have barakah. May Allah save us from that. And the worst the Shaykh said is when the Imam is reading, someone is reading.
It's terrible.
And we used to have that problem here every Ramadan.
Another sister was
especially from the sister section. To be honest with you, it's terrible. They are reading, the Imam is reading. Another sister wants to show that
mashallah, we have two.
Al-Hayakum Mutakathur, mashallah, he's there as well. She's leading that way in the little section. So we do have one Imam, we have two Imams.
Allahu Akbar.
So now the only one look at that one, can you be quiet?
And he calls
and the Aisalah. And imagine when that one look at you, who are you to talk to me? And now it takes further more, right? And it causes chaos,
making someone lose and all problems.
Maybe grudge.
And we don't want that.
And also as well, it might end up making someone lose all the reward of Ramadan.
They get
and we don't want that one. Inshallah, the shayukh and everyone will be announcing that in Ramadan. Not only in our masjid, they get so many masajid all over the world. Even in a haram.
Because they cannot.
In a haram, they are there. They are reading Islam. You would even want to leave them to go and start somewhere else. Because they cannot make it concentrate.
We should abstain from
that. May Allah guide all of us. So the shaykh talked about that extensively. And then the Sheikh said it's a big answer, we should abstain from that. And then he said,
if you don't do it, Ramadan,
for sisters who have missed the days, please do it now before Ramadan comes. And if you don't do it, seek Tawbah during Ramadan, but forget that then Allah is ahaq and you do that. The death of Allah Ta'ala has priority to be paid. So you must fast it as well after Ramadan. So I was assuming when the Sheikh was talking that some sisters they already go 6-7 Ramadan already.
That's why I gave you this time.
They put it there, Allah has taken it. Everybody come, Allah understand. Allah understand, alhamdulillah. That's why I gave you this time. But however, finally the Sheikh talked about some sisters who take pills all over the world. They call it from Ramadan, from Hajj. And then the Sheikh talked something very important. The hadith and the deen. He said, this is ruqsat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you this permissibility.
You don't have to pray.
This opportunity. He said, no problem. This license that has given to you,
if you don't
come to Alhamdulillah,
you don't have to pray.
And you don't have any problem for that. Then but Sheikh said the most important thing here is if you don't want to take that ruqsa, that license is given to you by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you want to take the pill as long as the pill does not cause harm. And if he causes harm, you know better than I do anyway. And maybe you will explain to the Sheikh more. But as long as he causes harm, then abstain from that.
Allahu A'lam.
May Allah reward the Sheikh. This is the summary the Sheikh have explained to us today. Now we will allow everyone, because this is the last session we are going to have in congregation here in the hall. And from the next Saturday, inshallah, you will hear us from downstairs from different settings. And inshallah, the masjid will be in a different atmosphere completely. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us miss the month of Ramadan. And then before we give you the opportunity, we want you to understand and to know.
Be here with us, inshallah, from
inshallah, Sheikh Abdullah bin Muhammad Al Madruj will be here with us, inshallah, from Mecca, from Saudi Arabia, who will be leading us in Taraweeh in this masjid.
Yeah,
and that will be on the 20th, the 2nd of June. Inshallah, we'll be here on Friday, the first Friday of Ramadan.
Happy to be with you.
Bi-idhnillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's very happy to come and be here. He said, I'm very, very excited, happy to be with you, inshallah. Any question, comments, or remark, may Allah pass it on to the Shaykh now. Mashallah, just one or three in one. Mashallah.
Yes, one of the things that we should is the for us to start to you know, before we start an argument, say you have a brother, right? That's somebody that we should, right? That you had an argument with or something like that, or whatever.
If for argument, say you have a brother, right? That's somebody that, right? And start to say to them, look, you had an argument with or something like that, you know what I mean? Are done. You know, start before Ramadan starts, and start to say before we talk about
forgive me for what I've said
and are done.
Should we start that?
You know what I mean?
Start clearing ourselves first, and you know, before we actually go into this Ramadan.
So
That's not true.
Now, my brother is asking a very, very important question. Probably, yes. How this kind of session or khutbah about the month of
Ramadan. My brother is asking a very, very important question. Probably, yes. How this kind of session or khutbah about the month of Ramadan or you. Pre-Ramadan
forgiveness, call
sessions.
Someone who
say that
you might have wronged,
shouldn't we?
Knowingly or unknowingly, ask the brother,
myself
brother,
or you,
please forgive
seek forgiveness. Call someone who you might have wronged. Knowingly or unknowingly, ask the brother, please, brother, I've wronged you, please forgive me. Seek forgiveness from my brothers and sisters that you've wronged. And then one, as he believes as well, one should purify their inner soul before the month of Ramadan. Because you should not stand in the month of Ramadan, the inner soul is dirty. It's filthy. So shouldn't we do that, Sheikh? The brother is asking.
Alhamdulillah.
He said you should answer to that question. Answer.
Alhamdulillah, In one hadith, 70 times, specifically another one, 100 times.
But also,
asking, yes, Alhamdulillah.
Ramadan is an also cautious about your
specifically only for Ramadan.
But also, if you offended your brother or sister,
and you ask for forgiveness, Alhamdulillah, it's good. And also,
the idea of making just specifying
in terms of
only for do not forget
this idea of when making motor specifying only for Ramadan. Do not forget the previous concept
till another
fast amount of Ramadan and you do your daily prayers.
As well as you continuously wrong
till another Ramadan, the sins in between that will be forgiven. As well as if you wrong your brother or your sister, then in between that time, even you should not be waiting only.
But if you realize before the Ramadan
is here, or when you are starts past the month of Ramadan, but if you realize before the Ramadan
comes
or starts, Alhamdulillah,
is only one between you and mankind.
Good. To ask for forgiveness because the sins between you and Allah is between you and Allah. But the one between you and mankind, Allah says, not forgive you, except you ask for repentance for your forgiveness from your brother or sister.
They must ask forgiveness all the time. Right? You mean your brother? Because this one is specifically about your fellow being that you oppressed.
Yes. Fasting is in order to gain. You see, taqwa, isn't it? Because she said at the end of the day you want to gain one. Fasting is in order to gain.
Whenever.
At taqwa, isn't it?
How for us, yes. Right, well, always says.
And to gain the taqwa,
your clothes is dirty.
Whenever.
What will you,
you have for us, I always says.
What is more important to you?
Your clothes is dirty.
Or the soul.
What will you like to take?
So obviously.
Yeah?
What is more important to you? Perfume or
because it's dirty. So if your heart is dirty, the first thing for you in order to get the taqwa,
isn't it?
You can't do what?
Because it is dirty. So if your heart is dirty, the first thing for you in order to get the taqwa, you have to do what?
Listen for you. Isn't it?
Yes. So don't look for the perfume.
So you have to clean
because the perfume will not make it. Listen for you. Isn't it, cameraman?
Inshallah, that's beautiful.
So you have to clean it first.
The purification of the inner soul. It's very important. In Allah, you
Inshallah, that's beautiful. The inner soul purification. The purification of the inner soul. It's very important. In Allah, you hibbu tawwabin wa yuhibbu mutatahhirin.
Now, any questions?
Allah loves those who purify their inner soul. And then turn to Allah in the repentance. SubhanAllah. May Allah reward you, Sheikh. Now, any question? Yes.
That's very beautiful, right? No, my auntie said that. Regarded
Allah. What about? That's very beautiful, right? No, my auntie said that. Regarded
Enjoy.
What about?
But you're still coming.
When you sleep.
3 years,
and by the time you wake up, because you are tired,
enjoy.
And then it's 5 hours.
Five. And suhoor was 4 o'clock.
Yeah, I want to make this when I say 5 past 5, because I'm referring to suhoor, it's 3 o'clock, for example.
Yeah, I want to make this when I say 5 past 5, because I'm referring to suhoor, it's 3 o'clock, for example. And then you wake up at 5 past 5, and suhoor 5 past 5. What should you do?
That's all what you have to do. And then you continue with your fasting. That's what you have to do. That's all what you have to do. And then you continue with your fasting.
I love that.
Because in the time of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, before, now we are very, very lucky. Before this ayat came, when
the person sleeps,
when the time comes for him to break their fast,
5 minutes or 10 minutes, and they say, okay.
If the person sleeps before the time, maybe 5 minutes or 10 minutes,
during the first time,
I had to. And the person sleeps
and he wakes up maybe after
and
1 hour
not
or so.
During that particular time, that 5 minutes time,
no have marital relation.
And he wakes up maybe after 1 hour or so. He cannot eat or drink again, no have marital relation. And he has to continue fasting until the next morning, which is the school time. That he has to take his suhoor and so forth. But one day Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he saw someone whose name was Sarma al-Ansari. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam saw him and he was so
during the daytime, and I'm fasting.
I'm working during the daytime, and I'm fasting. So when I came, I was so tired, and it was just a few minutes before
and I wake up
the iftar, so let him lie down
and have to wait. And that's why,
unfortunately, I overslept.
And it was not long.
And I wake up very late.
Okay.
So I have to continue. Said that's what you have seen.
Oh, mercy of Allah.
Yet it was not allowed to me. Umar ibn Khattab was okay.
He
said, oh, Messiah of Allah, what had something had happened to me? He said, what is it? He said, because I did something in the night.
Because when you sleep in the night, when you sleep in the night, oh, the woman
I slept. Because when you sleep,
you can
not
wake her to have marital relations with her in the night.
Oh, the woman sleeps.
You cannot also
wake her. Once you cannot wake her to have marital relations with her.
After you woke up.
And you cannot also do it. Once you have slept.
Until Allah
said it. After you woke up. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did not say anything until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala
implored
for
Allah
has made it possible for you that in the night you will be able to
after
your return blessing to your
destiny.
And also you are allowed also to eat after the sun sets until
time comes.
When?
You can eat and
until the Fajr
sleep. And then you wake up, you can still
the Fajr time comes.
So that's
you can eat and drink. Even though you sleep, and then you wake up, you can still eat.
Thank you for clearing this question.
So that's the verses of Allah has
been especially when he said sleeping,
how to tell him.
So he's very, very concerned about asking
the question. Especially when he said sleeping, wake him up. He's very, very concerned about asking to wake him up. MashaAllah, thank you very, very much. Inshallah, don't worry, you can sleep. And then you wake up, inshallah. Naam, sister.
The Sheikh was saying about during Tarawih.
Okay.
People are reading during Tarawih and saying that it's not permissible. But what can you do to maintain your concentration?
Okay.
Because not everybody understands Arabic, so it's
beautiful.
Like
the sister is asking, saying, the Sheikh said, especially people who are holding Quran with the intention of reading
beautiful.
It. What
the sister is asking, saying, the Sheikh said, especially people who are holding Quran with the intention of reading it. What the Imam is reading,
obviously, yeah. And this like, is the same, okay, really, and sometimes some people as well, they don't know Arabic. And
then you have really,
she's wonderful.
Yeah, yeah. What are and this is the same, okay, to sometimes some people as well, they don't know Arabic.
During that solar,
and then they want to she's wondering, for you to start what are the things that you can do to attain khushu during that solar, just for you to attain khushu, for you to stand there contemplating, and then mashallah, with all humbleness or humility in front of Allah, what are the advices you would have for us?
Listen to the recitation of the Quran. By listening to it,
first of all, Allah has said, listen to it. Listen to the recitation of the Quran. By listening to it itself, it makes you become more satisfied. Okay. And the next thing, you concentrate, you focus on where you are going to
not looking
make your
one and so on.
Okay,
so
you concentrate on that part also.
What is one? Some people
not
so not they go as far as
and so on and so forth.
Describing what the person
what this one is wearing. Some people even subhanAllah, you go as far as
in that light.
Describing what this person is wearing.
Or how many times
those who are in front of them in that light. What this one is wearing, what this one is not wearing, this one, or how many times he has worn that particular dress to come and so on and so forth. It's not for sure. It is not something. You have concentrated more on what you want. Listen to the body Quran. Quietly, and so forth. And if you can listen to it, you will even cry.
So that is what you have to do. And once
you even cry, it goes into your heart. But just listen to
sure that you
okay. So that is what you have to do. And once you do that, inshallah, it will help you to get your khushu that you need.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Okay.
The Sheikh is asking, when we pray Taraweeh, sometimes some brothers or sisters, they leave the...
When we pray Taraweeh, sometimes some brothers or sisters, they leave the
sunnah
with her.
Do we do so?
Yeah.
Or worship
with her? Shefa with her, they said, okay, because I want to stand in the night to pray. Is this a sunnah?
Sure
do we do so? Or worship with her?
It said, whosoever
pray. All right. I'm sure that you will understand the question. Said, whosoever performs that salat in the night with the Imam, until the Imam finishes the salat, the Imam performs a listen also with it.
All the salat.
Shepherd with it. With it.
It's better.
Therefore, it is better to be
in the night.
To finish.
You can get up in
all
the night.
The salat.
And still pray.
It's better to finish it.
Abu Huraira,
in the night, you can get up in the night and still pray because Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, he said, my friend, referring to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, had commanded me to lose my tenants and I should not leave them.
That I should perform my
will. And among them is
among the
things that are called anna.
One, some people say, oh,
that I should perform my witr before I sleep.
That question
for
that person.
Before I sleep.
3 days. One.
Okay. And among the things that I have to do.
3 days.
In one, each some people say, oh, what are those things as well? The question will come after that. So instead of
waiting for
that
person,
okay. 3 days. One. There is going to fast. 3 days. In each one.
To perform a witr.
To fast 3 days in each fast. And secondly,
because
performing salat to Dhuha.
No salat to Dhuha. The sister was asking here.
Everybody knows, isn't it?
You can
okay.
Oversleep.
And the third one, to perform a
witr. Until in the first time itself,
before
even
I sleep.
Fast.
Because it gives you that peace of mind. The same thing the sister was asking here.
The witr with the imam.
You can
you finish,
oversleep.
You go home,
isn't
and
it?
Allah bless you.
Until with the Fajr time itself,
whatever
time
you want to
pass,
you pray two in twos.
So, in order to avoid that,
every two
you better perform the witr with the Imam. When you finish, You go home and Allah bless you when you wake up in the night, or whatever time you want to do, you pray two in twos. Every two rakat, you make your salah. Every two rakat, you make your salah. You can pray and rakat or whatever, no problem. But you do not go another water. Because Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam asked Abu Bakr Siddiq and Umar bin Khattab regarding the witr.
And Umar,
he asked Abu Bakr Siddiq, when will you perform your witr?
In the night.
Abu Bakr Siddiq said,
before my witr and so forth,
I perform my witr before I sleep. Prophet Sallallahu
Alaihi Wasallam said, Abu Bakr, you have taken the rukhsah. Okay.
And Umar says, I perform my witr when I wake up. In the night, and I perform my Tahajjud and so forth, I finish my prayer. The Prophet said, Abu Bakr, you have taken the rukhsah.
All these things is a very good, it's a very good
thing. It is the license from
somebody. You get the presence, as then you have performed and so forth.
And Umar, you have taken al-azim, the hardest part of it.
So finish with it,
okay? All these things is a very good, it's a very good question. You finish with the imam, you get the blessings as if you have performed the whole of
that salat. Which means both of them are accepted in the sunnah, inshallah. Whichever is easier for you and for myself.
When you go home, Allah bless you and wake up.
Allah will not give you a burden.
Which means both of them are accepted with Sunnah, inshallah. Whichever is easier for you and for myself, let's do it. La yukallifu Allahu nafsan illa wus'aha. Allah will not give you a burden. You cannot carry, inshallah. Two more questions.
Whether you have to write, Sheikh asked me to write that. Whether you should
perform
ghusl before Ramadan, when Ramadan comes. My dear brother,
they said whether,
because some people, they said Ramadan has come, I have to
whether you have to write,
Janaba,
that you make the ghusl,
that Allah has to have the ghusl with it, then he has to have that. But apart from that, because of the coming of Ramadan, and hence you're making the ghusl, you don't have anything like that.
The fast
that you make the ghusl for Salat,
as long as you don't have any kind of janaba
before you go,
that you have already had a ghusl.
That means you take your shower and everything, but before you go perform Salat.
Okay, the final question.
For the fasting, as long as you don't have any kind of janaba that you have already had it, then there's nothing about that at all. So,
okay, the final question.
Alhamdulillah,
we've come to.
If Fajr comes. The forbidden time,
where would Fajr come, first of all, in between the forbidden time?
Then should you pray after the Yusufur?
That's why I was
completely confused. If Fajr comes in between the forbidden time,
good.
Now, so why would Fajr come?
And we're coming to the end of the session, my dear brothers and sisters, fathers as well as mothers. We want to show that gratitude to all of you. Okay. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Man la yashkur nas, la yashkur Allah. Or la yashkur Allah, man la yashkur nas.
Good.
Anyone
now,
who does not show gratitude.
And we're coming to the end of the session, my dear brothers and sisters, fathers as well as mothers. We want to show that gratitude to all of you. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Man la yashkur nas, la yashkur Allah. Or la yashkur Allah, man la yashkur nas. Anyone who does not show gratitude to his fellow being, he will never be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we are very grateful for your presence and support throughout the whole year. The imams, the executive, the members of the centers, I thank you again and again. Pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts it from you and all of us. I want you to join me as well to thank my humble father, Sheikh Sheikh Abdul Qadir Al-Buwani, for his wonderful contribution and commitment as well to the center, that he has to cancel all his sessions every week, anyway, on Saturdays, to be on the TV, brother to start his family. And he knows that we have the priority to get his own services, because we are his family, right? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us, he said, "Wandir ashirataka al-aqrabin." Start with yourself and your closest family, your relatives. So we have to make sure our homes and house is in order before we go and put other people's home in order, right? Alhamdulillah, that's what the Sheikh is doing here. He said charity begins at home. So may Allah reward him to talk about what he's doing. I'll never stop until Fajr. Alhamdulillah, other wonderful khair. This is just from a good way of showing gratitude to someone who has allowed you. Our brother Sheikh Musa and all the shuyukh, Sheikh Mimba Ghairi, all of them. And all the shiurs that come, wherever they come from, the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will all for this wonderful contribution. So we will come to the end of the session today. Until after Ramadan again, we have the settings. But the lectures continue. Kabita Fasir, Tafsir, like we do every Ramadan, or same lessons learned as well from the Quran. We continue, inshallah, with the Sheikh and the other Shiuch, inshallah. And you will have the audios, videos all being posted to you probably every day, inshallah. Every 2-3 days, even of every day, inshallah. So, Jazakumullah khairan, barak lana wa rahmana, wa sallana wa afu anna, wa tajawazin sayyatina, wa tawaffani ma'a al-durar. Allahumma barak lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban, wa balligna Ramadan ya kareem. Allahumma as'aluka an la taj'alna fi maqamina hadhihi dhanban illa ghafarta, wa la 'aiban illa satarta, wa la hamman illa faradta, wa la daynan illa qadayta, wa la maridan illa shafayta, wa la durra jami'a Allahumma hadayta. أسألك يا كريم أن تعفى عن مكرك وغلبك عنا ولا تؤاخذ خير الله بلا فعلنا ولا تؤاخذ خير فعل سفه منا اللهم وحد صفوفنا اللهم وحد صفوفنا اللهم وحد صفوفنا وحدنا جميعا إلى جنتك يا الله جنات النعيم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم نسألك خير المسألة وخير الدعاء وخير الحياة وخير الممات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات من عذاب الحساب اللهم لا تميتنا عنا وأنت راض عنا يا الله أمتنا مسلمين توفنا مسلمين وألحقنا بالصالحين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وصل اللهم على سيدنا محمد وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك ونشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
Hi, Mubarak in advance. Yeah, very sorry today we don't have the food. They said you start fasting now. So, this one will be.